Just got a little health warning. We'd just like to say about our next act that there is nothing about it which is libelous. It might seem like it's libelous, but it isn't. It's okay. We've checked with the solicitors and the accountants. In fact, and it's legal, it's fine. I've been reliably informed. So if anybody starts thinking that it is a bit libelous, it isn't. It's all perfectly legal. Absolutely legal. No libelous at all, whatsoever, etc. So, I want to introduce the Anti-Duhring Battalion.
Thank you very much. My name's Nick Draper. I'm the Conservative councillor for Collierswood of Merton. And I used to be mayor, and I'm not anymore, which is a shame, isn't it?
Oh, no, it isn't.
Oh, yes, it is. Do you remember all that? Oh no, it's... Oh yes it is! He's behind you! Do you remember that? Do you remember all that? Anyway, now just before we start the show, I just want to say a bit about why we're all here tonight. Because that event, which happened less than a month ago now, will be etched, and where we were and what we were doing will be etched deep within all our memories for probably about another week. I remember exactly where I was. I was out with Keith issuing an eviction order on one of my constituents when I received a phone call which I had long been dreading. I answered the call and it told me that a post-mortem examination on the body of Margaret Thatcher had confirmed that she was dead. Now I would like to say I never actually met Mrs. Thatcher, but I would like to say on behalf of Carol, Mark and Dennis that she'll be very proud of what you've achieved here today. In fact, it's an incredible testament to an amazing lady. And, I just want to say that I think what I was most struck by was the spontaneous outburst of grief which caused everybody to rush onto the streets of Brixton. I was there with Keith, shaking everybody's hands. I never knew there were so many Conservative Party supporters in Brixton. And the way that they were moving the letters on the Ritzy Cinema, it really was, for a lifelong Tory, quite moving. And
They're real.
They're the ones that I actually cried on the day. To show you the effect that it had on me. I know exactly how George Osborne felt. Believe me. Going back to that day really brings it all back to me. Now, I haven't seen Dennis in a while, but if I do see him at a social function in the near future, I'm sure to tell him to let him know what you all think of him and his dead wife. Now, I don't believe that there should be division at a time like this. You know, I believe that I'm a bit of a maverick. You could say I'm a bit of a lefty because I wear jeans with a tie and a blazer. I'm a bit like Boris Johnson and David Davis all rolled into one. And I want to say that it's been an amazing sort of few days, but for me it's been quite an emotional experience, and I just wanted to say that because I think you needed saying. Thank you very much. Okay, on with the show. Now, it's warm, isn't it, at the moment? Isn't it warm? It's warm, isn't it? But before, it was cold, wasn't it? And you know what? Whenever it's warm, it always reminds me of when it was cold. Do you remember that? When it was cold just a bit ago. And it's not now, but it was before, wasn't it? You know, and your fingers were all tingly and your toes were cold, you know. You know, not now, but before it was, wasn't it? Do you remember that? Do you remember that? And, you know, you come in and you'd have a red nose and... You know what? I know a song about somebody with a red nose. If you know the words, sing along. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Oh. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you lead my sleigh tonight? Oh, how the reindeer loved him, and they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. Tell you a funny thing about that song. Most people can't stand it. They find it really irritating. But it's a song that never goes out of season. And I see it as a kind of a message song, because it tells you how important it is for people to like you. Because no one liked Rudolph, did they? But the other thing is, it also says that unless somebody important does like you, you're worthless. Now, everybody, I've got a question for you. Is there anybody here who likes laughing?
Yes.
Yeah? Is that quite a few? Yeah? That like laughing, yeah? Well, those that do are in luck, because you're going to love the next bit. The next bit has been designed specifically for people who like laughing. And the reason why I say that is because one of the things that I do besides music is comedy. Now, we haven't started the comedy yet. He's laughing. We haven't started the comedy yet. When we start the comedy, I'll tell you. Because it's going to be... right, okay, we're going to do the comedy now. Okay, right. Now, does anybody remember the pop singer Kenny Rogers? Do you remember him? Do you remember him? Well, Kenny Rogers is going to an awards ceremony. And he's on his way to the awards ceremony. So he goes to a clothes shop, and he gets dressed up, and he puts on his cowboy hat, puts on his all his stuff, he looks fantastic. He puts on his cowboy boots, about 3 inches high, and it's the night of the awards ceremony, and the man's saying, and ladies and gentlemen, on stage is Kenny Rogers. Kenny Rogers hears it, and he's on his way up, he's going onto the stage, he's going up, looks down, and he goes, you picked a fine time to leave me. Loose heel. Now, does anybody understand that joke? Let me explain it to you. Kenny Rogers had a pop song, and in it he went, you picked a fine time to leave me loose heel. Now, that's how you tell a joke. Now, any comedians... they're in the house, right? Notes for comedians. Always try to explain your jokes after you've told them. Like I just did there. Did you see how I did that? That way, those that haven't understood them will understand them and will therefore laugh. Also, say your jokes in a clear voice. If you say your joke and they haven't laughed, it means that they haven't heard it, so say your joke again. Now, being a Conservative councillor, it's very easy to fall into the category cunt. That's not a word that I use to describe myself. That's a word that other people use to describe me. Let's make that clear. Now, as I say, I'm going to show you that that's not the case. I've been involved in an initiative with Keith, and we've put out, and it's called Make Collierswood Happy. And we've put out a newsletter, and we've really pushed, and we've really worked, and we've really, really, really pushed it, and we finally, we've managed to get a family evicted from Cavendish Road. And all my sources at the council, and I've got no reason to believe them, to disbelieve them, sorry, have informed me that they were Irish. And the other thing is that I don't know if anybody's seen that horrible eyesore in Collierswood. It needs bringing down. It's ugly. It's bringing all the prices, the house prices down in the area. What do they call it? Keith's written it down for me. Just hang on a second. St George's Hospital. That's it, yeah. Now, all the money that's going to be raised from that initiative, and all the stuff that we're getting from the bingo and everything like that, it's all going to go to a very good cause, which I promise you will make no actual change to the situation in any way whatsoever. So there won't be anything controversial like funding IRA gun running or anything like that, because I don't like that. Now, what's that you say? Say, what was that? You want another song? You want another song? Okay. Just hang on a second. This is one that we used to do in the old people's home before I closed it down. Now, it's an audience participation one, so, you know, do feel free to join in. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Have you got the idea? Okay, let's try again. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Tingle. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. And eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Head, shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. I really think that that song's about me. I feel like it's like an autobiographical song in a way. Because I've got a head, shoulders, knees and toes, eyes, ears, a mouth and a nose. But that's not all that I am. I'm also, spare me a second, this is my Conservative Party card. This is what I believe in, and this is what I've sacrificed the best part of my life for. It's my total identity. It's got my name, Nick Draper, and it's got, it says Labour. Oh, it's a Labour Party. Oh, I'm in the Labour Party. Oh, I'm a Labour councillor. I'm a Labour councillor. Okay. Well, the thing is, I don't read these very much anyway. I don't think you really need to. They're not that important. What my parents used to say to me was, it doesn't matter who you work for, just as long as you're paid well and you enjoy yourself. I think everybody does, don't you? Is this working? Don't you? Right. So anyway, I'll have to leave you there because I've got a council meeting in a couple of months' time. But I do want to say that it really has been a privilege tonight, not just for you, but for the borough as a whole. And also, I've learned something about the important work that I'm doing in this big society of ours. So let's thank the Anti-Duhring Battalion for allowing me to stand in for him, as he sometimes does, and say, I hope you have a lovely evening. Thank you very much.